Okay, I had some great questions from an email about going from pharmacy tech to pharmacist, and I thought I'd make a video because this is something obviously we do here at community college quite a bit. Actually half of my students in the pharm tech program get 2 degrees. They get their pharmacy technician diploma as well as an AAAS or AGS. So the first thing is, how do pharmacy schools look at community colleges, community college credits? Well, fully half of students going to pharmacy school have some kind of community college credits. Why is it that there's maybe stigma issues with it? It really comes from a myth, which is that credits at community college are not as difficult as they are at the state school. It's tough to take a class at a state school because there's a class of 100 and that you've got TAs instead of full professors. We're here at DMAC, we've got PhDs teaching all the organic classes who have had and care about the teaching, not any research program. So the hard and why it's more difficult is really a weed out process that has nothing to do with good teaching. Are any classes in pre-pharmacy don't transfer over? It depends on the college that you're applying to, but in general, the pre-pharmacy classes all transfer over. How to make it easier in terms of part-time. So you can go part-time to pre-pharmacy. Now, part-time pharmacy is a completely different entity. So there is a lot of talk at AACP, which is the American Association of Colleges of Pharmacy, of doing part-time or offering part-time for pharmacy programs because there are some underserved groups that simply can't do the full-time thing, even with the loans and things like that. It's just not possible, and a bit too much of a stretch. So my recommendation there is that I know personally now at least one Creighton student and some others that have gone to their online program. And I know that some students do 20 hours a week, some students do full time. That's rare, but I would actually recommend that program if you want something like that, especially in the Midwest. And then the tuition itself. So are there scholarships for tuition? I just met Jocelyn from the scholarship system, and she is actually got a tremendous number of free advice, free webinars, sheets, and things like that. I would start with her free programs, and then if you want to certainly work with her, I don't know what the cost is of her program, but I know she's got some excellent advice. We'll have her on the Pharmacy Podcast here in a couple weeks. Who should we network with? That has done it successfully. Your financial pharmacist has a lot of good podcast episodes if you just want to go to work and kind of listen to some of the things that people are doing after school. They haven't really talked too much about during school, more of the kind of advice that you would have to, try to minimize it, staying at home versus those things. But actual scholarships for pharmacy, again, Jocelyn mentioned that some of the techniques she's used have been able to do it, but they have to be sophomores, at least in pre-pharmacy, because they want to make sure that you're actually going to go to that school. How does the financial aid process work and getting loans? Financial aid, I would actually just recommend you go to the financial aid office at DMAC. They'll explain everything to you. I would get too far in the weeds there. And they'll tell you which ones you want to look at and things like that. And then just overall, is this something that is a possibility? And absolutely, it's a possibility. We've had a number of techs, and one tech I was just talking to is at a top school over at Kentucky. A number of our students have gone to local colleges here in Des Moines and the University of Iowa as well, and then Creighton. So, and then I also heard Midwestern, and I'm not sure if they went to Arizona or Illinois, but our students here have gone nationally because we're also one of the top 10 community colleges in the country as well. Thanks for the questions, but again, I always appreciate those questions. It helps me direct some of the videos that I make. And again, please throw some comments in. I'll be happy to answer them.